look.
I am not looking.
Don't look.
My eyes are closed. Okay.
Okay.
It's a movie.
Yes.
It stars people.
Yes.
It's Hindi.
Yes.
Amitabh Bachchan.
Yes.
Black.
No.
Sholay.
No.
Okay. SRK?
Nope.
Okay. Newer?
No.
It's older.
Yes.
The one I don't like.
Amir Akbar Anthony?
Yeah.
No.
Okay. Older and we've seen it.
Yes.
And it's not Sholay, it's not Amir Akbar Anthony.
Mm-hmm. We even reacted to a scene from it.
Oh crap. His breakthrough one.
No.
No?
Anand?
Yeah.
No.
Crap, I don't know.
Divar.
Oh! Juice!
Hey, welcome back to our stupid reaction. It's Korbins.
I'm dumb.
And you can follow us on Instagram, Twitter for more juicy content. Thanks on Patreon. Follow our Twitter account. Subscribe to our stupid reactions.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Do it.
La 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 la. Today we got a information. This is India taking over VFX industry?
No.
So this is about, obviously, I don't know if it's out already, but we saw a quarter crew reacting to RRR. But this is a overall them talking about India and taking over.
Well,
in terms of not just India stuff, they're doing Hollywood stuff for Hollywood.
Yes,
and all that kind of stuff.
So yeah, I mean, we've talked about this before, just in the 3 years we've been watching the evolution of the visual effects in India. They went from being way behind to now not just on par, but right on that leading edge.
Yeah, and the only reason you'll see any difference is because they won't spend as much here as you're going to spend in
America. But like, I know, for example,
but
I don't know how many
companies.
We were told this from Minimanari. We were told this for RRR, that the VFX houses, which is the truth for a lot of industries all over the world, it's no longer homegrown. It's VFX places all over the planet. You can have 10 different places working on your VFX stuff in different countries. So I'm interested to see this, but yes, it is.
I wanted
massive
alcohol.
I'm with you. I already been to the gym, so I can imbibe with you.
Here we go.
Nice.
In 2011, the size of the Indian VFX industry was around $31 billion. But within 10 years, it has risen to massive $74 billion. With international companies like MPC, Double Negative, Framestore, or Digital Domain establishing their offices there, and now shifting from rotoscoping and cleanup to creative visual effects creation, India's VFX industry will surely continue to grow. Having its own huge film industry, India has also established its own VFX companies over the years. What made the Indian VFX
Shower Khan's Red Chilies
constantly in the last decade? Let's find out.
Shower Khan. The King did.
This video is sponsored by F-Truck, the creator of Academy
this
Award
video is
and
not.
Emmy-winning production tracking and media review solutions for VFX and other creative industries.
Hey, Stranger Things.
I'll tell you more about it at the end of this video. And now let's talk about India's VFX industry. The turning point was in the 1990s, when CGI, computer-generated imagery, started gaining importance, and that was also noticed by the Indian industry. Soon, Indian companies decided to advance themselves to match with international competitors. Until recently, everyone associated India with rotoscoping. It was the number one place for outsourcing this kind of work. Also, so-called paint and cleanup work, which usually means
wire removal,
manually painting out unwanted objects, was being sent to India. Big VFX companies, like the mentioned NBC, have established their branches in India to have their own teams for such work. However, a gigantic film industry, there's around 1,800 films being produced in India each year compared to around 700 made in Hollywood, clearly developed a need for visual effects. Due to relatively lower budgets, those effects had to be created locally, and so India's VFX studios began to emerge. Prime Focus, Makuta VFX, or Red Chilies are just a couple of examples of India's VFX powerhouses. Those companies are responsible for some amazing effects created for Indian films, but they begin to spread on international productions. Red Chilies is one of the leading firms in the country that has now more than 300 artists working for them. Their scope of work ranges from beauty work, environments and set extensions, creature creation,
best in the biz right now,
simulations. Their credits include some Indian blockbusters, but they also had a bite on international productions like Sin City 2 or League of Gods.
Dang.
VFX is not just about film projects. Commercials are today in demand for visual effects as well. One of the leading firms, named Famous Studios, claims to deliver 15 to 20 TV ads each month with heavy VFX work. Along with the VFX industry, the animation studios in India bloom, and companies like Green Gold Animation or Toons Animation are producing dozens of animated films and series for Indian and international markets.
Oh, really?
India's VFX industry is quickly catching up with the latest technology trends. It's no different with the virtual production. Stages with LED screens, as originally used in the production of Mandalorian, are being built in India and were used to continue producing movies during the pandemic. Actually, despite the massive impact of COVID-19, the animation industry in India grew by 10% in 2020, while the whole economy was going down.
Mm.
Some of India's biggest films featuring heavy VFX work include Bahubali, produced in 2015 with a budget of approximately $28 million and 90% of the movie having some kind of visual
effects. That's insane.
Created by 17 VFX studios and around 600 artists. In 2020,
imagine if they spent the amount of money we spend here.
Will be released.
Oh, yeah.
In 2018 science fiction film, being the most expensive Indian film so far, with around $76 million budget. Visual effects were created by Double Negative and 22 other companies, and animatronic effects by US-based
Green Akshay
Legacy Effects, known for Avatar, Avengers, or Jurassic World. Zero, a 2018 romantic comedy for which the main actors fight, had to be reduced to around 137 centimeters. Visual effects were provided by Red Chilies VFX.
Amazing.
Over the years, the demand for visual effects all over the world has increased dramatically. VFX studios were opening branches in different parts of the world to catch up with the demand and to gain access to new artists. In the meantime, VFX artists in India gained experience and were now ready to move from simple tasks to more demanding ones. This is especially visible with
now RRR and
the London-based VFX company was bought by Indian Prime Focus in 2014. Originally, Dinex Indian offices were taking over rotoscoping and cleanup work. But recently, we see that more complex work, like compositing or FX simulations, are being done in their
Dune
branches. That was the case with Dune, Matrix Resurrections, or the Uncharted.
Top-notch VFX in that film.
The rapid growth of India's VFX industry is also influenced by government financial incentives and wider education possibilities, with universities offering VFX and animation studies. Some of the most known are Anibrain School of Media Design, MAAC, Maya Academy of Advanced Cinematics, National Institute of Design, or Sanpit University. Despite VFX industry growing constantly since the last decade, the younger generation in India and their parents are still facing difficulty getting out of the century-old mindset of pursuing career in law, government service, engineering, or healthcare.
Yeah.
But the career trends are quickly changing. Visual effects industry gets more recognition and starts offering good financial
Tell your kids
conditions.
To do something in computers.
Junior VFX artists
it's a good bet.
In India can earn around $150 to $350 US dollars per month. Mid-level artists can expect $400 to $800, and senior VFX artists earn up to around $1,500 per month.
Come to America.
Lead
it's
artists
not enough money.
And supervisor salaries can be substantially higher.
Obviously, I know India's cheaper. I
yeah,
get that.
The
I
cost
get
of
that.
Living.
India's VFX industry has now managed.
You'd be making six figures
of
here.
The global market, and is expected to rise by 25% in 2025.
Oh, on Technicolor.
India will take a large chunk of world's VFX production. However, with growing demand for visual effects...
Wouldn't be surprising if India becomes the leader.
I don't think that we would see an outflow of jobs from Europe or America. Huge number of film and episodic productions for numerous streaming platforms will simply create new opportunities for VFX artists around the world, including India. Now back to our sponsor, F-Track. F-Track Solutions help...
Yeah, it wouldn't shock me if in the next 10 years it kind of veers over to, like, Marvel stuff is being sent over to India. Not only because, obviously, the quality is good, but also the fact that they're going to be probably cheaper, too.
Yeah.
Unless India starts asking the normal prices of VFX companies in America,
right?
Maybe they already do. I have no clue what the asking rates for actual VFX companies are.
Neither do I.
But I know it's high.
Yeah, it's not going anywhere because so much visual effects work is. I'd love to know the ratio because it wouldn't surprise me if more visual effects work is done on simple VFX, like when they were walking down the hall and they just created the hallway chandelier.
Yeah.
Rather than building a set, I mean, you're going to be paying out for the CGI, but time is money. And so rather than have to do all that carpentry and have to set that up, to just be able to add what you need is huge.
It's even though it's cost a lot, it's cheaper to do VFX work than it is for lumber, man hours, all that kind of stuff.
Weather.
Yeah, it's quite insane.
So, it'll save
shock
time.
Me with, just also depending on Brahmastra,
yeah,
how well that film does and how good it looks in theaters, and we're obviously very hopeful.
Yeah, if it looks as good as the trailer.
For it, but the fact that RRR, obviously, even though we had issues with KGF2, the visuals were obviously gorgeous in KGF2 and Pushpa as well. The VFX weren't the issues
in
those films that we had with those films. So the fact that the artistry is already there, and now I wouldn't shock me if you just see companies now pouring money with the success that RR is having here in America, being like, please make more and give them $100,000, $100 million budgets.
Yeah, because the quality it's there now. Because
the only thing that's going to make it any better. Is you just pouring more money into it. Obviously, you have the talent of the directors, the actors, and outside of white artists.
And the artists.
Outside of white artists.
Yeah,
you can pour more money in there and get good artists.
Yeah, it's true. We know the reason for it. It really is true. You get what you pay for.
Yeah, we 100% know why there's bad white actors.
Yep.
It's quite obvious now. But just pour more money into it And I think companies are going to, you're going to start seeing more international stuff.
And they will when they see the returns they get on films like RRR. Mm-hmm. And that's why, again, on the one hand, when you're talking about the artistry of a film, the box office doesn't matter. That's not a measure of how good a film is or not. The thing that's important about the box office is what it does and communicates to the filmmakers and the distributors and producers. Because when a movie makes money, they take note and they make more movies like it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
it was a good video.
Great
video. Let us know what other videos we can react to. And if you're part of VFX, let us know down below. Come work for us. I don't know. Stay where you're actually going to make good money.
Make money.
Juice!